Hey, what is going on, guys? We are back with some more NCAA Football 13 Road to Glory, and we're finally back with this. I know it's been a lot of Far Cry going up, but you know, I gotta play that Far Cry, because Far Cry is amazing. But you know, let's get into this week. We are playing Wyoming, and this is gonna be the only game for this episode, because this game was absolutely ridiculous. Normally I do two games per episode, but you guys will see pretty soon that this game was pretty wild. So you see that we would jump from number 10 to number 6 in the BCS polls, and that is because Oregon would lose to Wisconsin 35-41 in overtime. Oregon would lose to Washington 28-35, and then scrolling down, Texas will lose to Oklahoma 21-31, and then you have Oklahoma State, who was number 6, and you know, they would lose to Kansas State 34-39. Surprisingly, Kansas State is number 21. I think they had a pretty good season last year. I don't know what they're doing this year. And you also see that finally, after that performance I had, that I am on the Heisman watch. That 24 for 25 game where my only incompletion was an interception, 374 yards, 9 carries, 94 yards rushing, 4 throwing touchdowns, and 1 rushing. And then you see the guys ahead of me. I mean, I can understand. Okay, you know what? This guy had a good game, but this guy here, what is this? 3 receptions for 35 yards, a touchdown, 20 carries, 108 yards. That's nothing. I mean, that's barely Heisman worthy. I mean, come on. He got a bigger jump than I did. And then you have the quarterback at Ohio State, who actually lost his game. He went 19 for 33, 264 yards, 13 carries for 64, and 2 touchdowns. I mean, come on. Why am I still stuck behind here? And then you have the running back at Georgia, who had, you know, not necessarily the best game. He had a touchdown, you know, 8 yards average receiving, about 5 yards rushing. You know, it's average. It's not that great of a game. I don't understand why I haven't moved up. But hopefully in this game against Wyoming, we can do that. You guys see that we're coming out in the orange and blue uniforms, which is, I don't really wear these because, I don't know. It's just because EA doesn't have the blue and orange shoes, so it kind of like the uniform doesn't really look as good as it's supposed to. But it, you know, it looks pretty decent here. You know, I got the blue sleeves, I got the blue accessories to offset the orange, and it looks pretty good. So, you know, we're heading to this game against Wyoming, and Wyoming, you know, pretty good game last year. It was kind of, you know, a lopsided game. I mean, they had some defensive plays here and there, but they really didn't do much. First play of the game, 1st and 10, we would get the ball first, and just like every other game, look at me taking off. That's 3 straight games where the first play of the game, I'm just taking off to run. 1st and 10, following that play, hitting Walker for the first down. He's going to pick up about 14, 15 yards right there, and then coming out 2 plays later, 2nd and 5, handing the ball off to Kerr. He's going to break a tackle and take it up for about 4.5 yards, make it a 3rd and inches. And then on 3rd and inches, we are running the speed option, which is not something I like to run because I normally get lit up just like that. I got laid out, but I do get up kind of slow. So I'm, you know, it's all good. I'm getting up once again. 1st and 10 following that play, handing the ball off to Kerr. Kerr is going to break this one and pick up about 5 yards once again. So Kerr is having a pretty good start to this season. You know, last year, Brown, our starting running back, he had a really hard time getting things rolling. And right here, I'm rolling to my right, you know, trying to draw those defenders away from Williams. But, you know, just talking about the rushing last year, it was just really bad. We didn't have a rushing offense at all, and it made it really hard to get things going. And right here, you see that Williams actually got injured on that last reception. So I have to, he's actually out of the game, and we actually have to, you know, look at what, that's a pretty nice pass. I mean, Lee got open, the slant route worked the way it was supposed to. And that was about a 2-minute drive there. We get the ball back with a little under 2 minutes left. So Wyoming gave us the ball back with, you know, about a 30-second drive. And you guys remember what happened last time. We were pinned up against our own goal line. It went for a touchdown. And this one is going to be no different. Williams running the fade route. He just runs to the middle of the field. I kind of just lob it because there's no safety overlooking the middle of the field. So I just toss that one up to Williams. He gets the touchdown. Cheerleaders are excited. We're up 13-0. This game is going the way we want it to. But Wyoming would score to make this a 7-14 game. And they're trying to keep this one close right here, hitting Harvey in between the zone coverage. He just sat in between the zone coverage on his route. And that play worked out perfectly. So we come out here once again on 2nd and 6. A play later after Kerr would pick up about 4 yards, rushing the ball. And I'm calling a bunch of hot routes. I think I was trying to get Harvey open on this play, but everyone is covered. I could have tossed that ball up to Walker, but I did not feel like risking it because that safety probably would have got back in a play and most likely picked me off. So now we're looking at a 2nd and 10, handing the ball off to Kerr on the halfback draw. And that play just does not work. So now we're looking at a 3rd and 14, And we're only up by 7 points here. We're trying to get some more points to increase our lead because Wyoming, I mean, these guys scored pretty quickly. So, I mean, that's all good looking here. Look at Lee. Lee's cutting to his left, making that reception, keep the toe in bounds, and that's going to be a first down. So we come out here running the jet sweep for Williams, something we normally don't do, but Williams takes this one up the field. And that, oh man, if Williams had a little more speed or if there was a little bit more blocking, that could have been a touchdown right there. And now we're looking at a 2nd and 4, dropping back to pass, and no one's open here. So I'm going to take off, bump the defensive lineman, pick up about 3.5 yards, make it a 3rd and inches. And then we come out here on 3rd and inches running the zone read, and I made the wrong decision. I should not have handed that ball off. The defensive lineman followed Kerr up the field. And for that reason, I decided to go no huddle. I was like, you know what, we can get this first down. The zone read should work. It worked last time against San Diego State, and I went for a touchdown. And this time, I decide to hang onto the ball, and I get destroyed. So that's a turnover. The defensive lineman just came straight at me, and that's going to be a turnover. So Wyoming would come down the field and tie the game up. So now it's a 14-14 game. Coming over here, hitting Williams for about 8 yards on that pass. And then coming out here on 3rd and 2, I am specifically looking for Walker to get open running the slant route. I hit him. And that linebacker came over and crushed him. I kind of left him out there to dry, and that is not all right. So we come back out on the field, and Wyoming once again would score. Now it's a 21-14 game, and we have to score here. We really do not have an option. Hitting Walker there, spins, bounces off the defender, picks up a huge first down. We have to get this ball moving down the field, running the ball here for Kerr to get a little bit of mix going on the offense. He picks up about 8 yards right there. And once again, what can I say about Kerr? This guy has just been outstanding. And we're going to go no huddle here to give him an opportunity to pick up the first down because we need this first down. He does do that. He picks up about 6 more yards to make this a 1st and 10 at about the 45-yard line. So we come out here once again, 3rd and 12, a couple plays later. And look at me hitting Walker. This should be a touchdown. But oh, look at that. Walker would drop the pass. And that's going to make this a 4th and 12. Obviously, we're not going for it. And, you know, Walker has been terribly unclutched lately. And it's just like it's... I mean, we're down 7 points. We need this touchdown. I mean, Wyoming's going up the field, and they're scoring every time they touch the ball. So I'm pretty sure that if this is probably the biggest drop of Walker's career. This is probably the biggest drop ever for Boise State, period. But Wyoming would not score. Defense comes up clutch, gets the stop. Now we're looking at a 21-14 lead with about 4 minutes left in the fourth quarter, and we have to get down this field and score. So now we're going no huddle here after that 7-yard completion to Walker. And I'm looking for Freeman to get open going deep. I see Freeman lob the ball up to him. And somehow that safety gets back into the play. I don't know exactly what happened there. But he got back into play. So running play action here. Looking for someone to get open. Once again, Williams just coming up clutch. He's just open when I need him to be open. And he catches that ball for the first down. So now we're looking at a 1st and 10 at about the 41-42-yard line. I'm looking for Walker deep. I'm telling Walker, get this ball. And look what he does. Walker goes up there, and he grabs that ball out of the air. And that was just, that play was gorgeous. I mean, come on, guys. That's a redemption play for Walker after that drop earlier. He made even a better play than before. I mean, he just went up there and just grabbed that ball out of the air. You guys are going to see the instant replay. Just look at that. I threw that ball behind him. I pulled back on it a little bit. And he just went up there and grabbed that ball out of the air. You see my stats for the game, 12 for 19, 266 yards. Not the most consistent game, but we are getting it done. So now we come back out on the field, and oh, look at that. Once again, Wyoming would score to make this a 28-21 game. And we're looking at a 2-minute drill right here. But I honestly do not need 2 minutes to go down the field and score. You know, obviously, you want to take it slow. Wyoming's been scoring. You don't want to give them, you know, enough time to go down the field and score. Everyone has 3 timeouts left, so you kind of want to play it carefully right here, handing the ball off, because we do want to burn a little bit of time and not necessarily give them all the time in the world to walk down the field and score with 3 timeouts left. So right there, hitting Williams for the first down. Williams doing his thing once again. I mean, Williams has been in and out of this game. He's been injured. Right here, going for Walker deep once again. And this ball, I don't know what happened there. It just got terribly underthrown. The pass trajectory system just really tweaked right there. But Williams does come back onto the field on this play, and look at Williams making an immediate impact every time he's on the field. Right there, getting crushed by the defender, but he does catch that ball. So defenders have to get hype here. They need to stop this upcoming possession. Coming out here second and 10 with about a minute left in the game, hitting Walker for the first down on the slant route. It's 3rd and 2. Williams, that last play was out once again, but this play, he is back in. I'm calling a slant for him specifically because I'm looking at this like the solo coverage on the running back. I know that linebacker is moving. Look at this. Williams just open in the middle of the field. Touchdown, Boise State. And that is going to make this a 27-28 game. And all we have to do is hope that, one, the field goal kicker doesn't miss the extra point, and two, that the defenders can hold off Wyoming so that we can get the ball back or at least go into overtime. That is the main thing I'm hoping for right here. We really need a stop. And right here, Williams, get hyped because you have probably been the main reason why we're back in this game. And look at this. We do get a stop. Wyoming does give us the ball back with 25 seconds left right here. I take off to run because I just did not want to throw that ball up in the air. That was probably going to be a terrible decision, especially because Wyoming has three timeouts left. An interception could be deadly. Right here on this play, going deep for Williams, and this ball just gets slightly overthrown. And that probably could have been a huge play to get us at least in field goal territory if that play was brought in. Right here, running the Hail Mary. And this is probably the worst example of the pass trajectory system flopping that the best example of it flopping. Because why would I throw a Hail Mary pass and that ball is like 10 yards short? I was trying to drive that ball down the field, but whatever. And now you see that we're going into overtime. We obviously select to go on defense, which is the thing that you want to do. But look at this. Wyoming doesn't even score a field goal in overtime. That is pretty much going to tell you guys how this game is going to end. First down, hitting Williams for about a 9-yard gain to make it second and inches. Coming out here in the no huddle because I'm literally sitting here like, you know what? I want this game to be over with. No more surprises. Let's get this game over with. No adjustments on this play. Dropping back the pass, hitting Lee, and he's going to bring this one down to about the 5-yard line. So on first and goal, I mean, this game's pretty much over with. Coach could come out here and kick a field goal if he wanted to, but I'm not going to let that happen. Coming out here, first and goal, rolling to my right, touchdown, Boise State. That pass was awesome. I mean, that was probably a risky pass because that defender was coming back to his left or to his right, coming back into the play. And look at Williams sitting in the end zone, calling for the ball, waving his hands like, I'm open. And look at him just bringing that ball in for the touchdown. And look at me getting hyped. This game is over. That is going to end this game. Defense is hyped because they did come up clutch in the fourth quarter. Well, not necessarily the fourth quarter, but closing out the game. Pretty clutch ending for the defense. You know, they got the stop in overtime, not letting them get down the field. And if you guys, I think there was like, I didn't check the play summary for the overtime. I think that I don't even like this play of the game. This was not the play of the game. The play of the game was Walker's touchdown catch. I understand that this was a 97-yard touchdown pass, but I mean, or 93, I think. Yeah, I think it was a 93, but I mean, still, this is like not the play that got us back into the game. That touchdown pass to Walker was the one that got us back into the game. You guys can see that that guy ripped his hoodie because of how stressful this game was. I mean, he's got a big patch in his hoodie because, oh man, this game, I can't tell you guys how stressed out I was playing this game. It was like, oh, we're going to lose to Wyoming. I can't take this. But we do come out and get the win, 20 for 31, 362 yards, 5 touchdowns, 9 carries, and 35 yards is going to be my stat line for the game. Not the best game, but we did get it done. Williams, Walker, Freeman, my receivers, and these guys, whoa, what is going on here? That's pretty weird. But we come out here and we're going to head into the next week of the season. Sorry I couldn't fit two games into this episode, but you guys understand why. I could not skimp on plays for this episode. It wouldn't have made sense what was going on. But our next game is going to be against the Nevada Wolfpack, and I'll try to have this next episode up as soon as possible. It's going to be two games in that one, guys, and I will see you later. Thanks for watching.